Here's how we're going to get the plumbing set up for the pump. On the top of the pump is a 3/4 inch female pipe thread, and that leaves us a couple of options on how we're going to hook up the rest of the system. One option is to use PVC pipe with a PVC pipe adapter. What we like is poly pipe. That leaves us two options here. We have 3/4 inch and 1 inch for our poly pipe, both of them with 3/4 inch fitting. Your system comes with a poly pipe adapter. If you request it, we can supply either 1 inch or 3/4 inch, which comes standard with kits. In order to get this set up, first we're going to take some Teflon tape, apply it to the 3/4 inch male side of the adapter. With the tape applied, we can now screw our barb into our pipe connection. So we're going to get it pretty snug here using our wrench. Not too tight that we crack the fitting, but tight enough that we're not going to get any leaking of water when it's under pressure. So right about there is pretty good. Using the standard hose barb, the water will naturally flow out of the drop pipe, back down through the pump, and into your well. This provides freeze protection in winter. But if you're using a pressurized system, that's not going to be useful for you because you need pressure to be held at the pump head. So what that's going to require is our check valve. So there's an arrow on the check valve with the direction of flow. In this case, we want it pointing up, and then we're going to use our 3/4 inch nipple in order to make the connection. Again, we'll use pipe tape on the pipe threads. Two or three layers is just fine. We'll need to do it on both sides for a nice waterproof connection. Looking at the arrow again, we'll thread it onto our one-way valve. And then we'll thread it onto the top of the pump. Once it's snug, we can use a wrench to ensure a nice, tight, waterproof connection. Now your barb or your PVC coupler will fit right on the top in order to connect your poly pipe or PVC pipe. From here, we're going to connect up our poly pipe. Our kit comes with two hose clamps, and normally, you'll be using a big roll of poly pipe. This here is about 50 feet of 1 inch poly pipe. You may be using longer for your installation, but for this demo, we're going to use a short piece of 3/4 inch poly pipe. First, we're going to apply our hose clamps onto our poly pipe. Then, we're going to put our poly pipe onto our hose barb. Should be a fairly tight fit. Most of the time, you'll be able to get it on without heating it up. But if you notice it's too tight of a fit, you can use a heat gun or a torch in order to soften the plastic slightly in order to get this on. Next, we're going to tighten down our hose clamps. You can use a screwdriver or a socket wrench in order to get a very tight fit. With our first hose clamp tightened, we're going to move on to our second hose clamp. One important note, you do not want both hose clamps lined up in the same spot. You want them offset by 180 degrees. This prevents any leakage through the flat spot on the hose clamps. With two hose clamps onto your barb, you're ensured a tight, waterproof fit. With your hose clamp secured, we do recommend covering up the hose clamps with some electrical tape. That'll do two things. One, it'll prevent chafing of your pump wire, and second, it'll prevent fraying of your safety line. It doesn't take too much, so we'll start just by doing a couple of wraps of electrical tape, and then working our way up to the top to cover up all of the exposed metal. This covers up the sharp edges of the hose clamps that are sticking out, and makes it overall a lot easier to work with when you're dropping the well pump down your well. So that's all you need in order to make a nice, safe covering for your hose clamps. So a safety line is not required for your installation, but it is recommended. What this is 1/4 inch polypropylene yellow cord. It's available online or at any of your big box retail stores. This is just a secondary safety measure. In case your drop pipe happens to break, you'll have a second way in order to pull up your well pump. All of our pumps come with 2 connections for the rope. We can pick one of them, insert it through the connection point, and then tie a good knot. In this case, we recommend a bowline for a nice, secure connection. Your safety line, your wire, and your drop pipe are all going to go up the well. In order to keep this manageable, we do recommend attaching them all together using electrical tape every about 5 to 10 feet or so. All it takes is about 1 wrap. That'll give you a secure connection. And from here, we can move on to the next spot. That way, everything doesn't get tangled and it stays in a nice, neat bundle. One of the best features of this system are the low water and tank full sensors. They're both the same, so you can use any. We're going to use some electrical tape in order to attach our low well sensor about 1 foot above our solar well pump. We can do about 2 wraps right above on the cord. And then we can also do 1 wrap right around the sensor. This is going to hold it in place and make sure it doesn't move around or get tangled. So what this low well sensor is doing is protecting the pump from running dry. If the pump runs dry, it can overheat and damage the motor or damage the pumping mechanism. What the sensor is doing is, as the water level drops in your well, if you have a lower producing well, as soon as it gets below this, it's sending a signal back to the controller and it's enabling the low water well protection. That stops the pump. It's no longer pumping until the water rises back above the sensor, and from that point, the pump will turn back on and start pumping until it drops again. With the basic setup coming off of your pump of your low water sensor, your rope, your drop pipe, and your drop wire, you're going to continue working your way up, taping this bundle to your drop pipe about every 7 to 10 feet. That'll keep it all in a secure bundle. Then you're ready to drop it down your well. So you take the whole thing and basically drop it right down your well.